Hey everybody, it's Shinobu Muhammad, editor-in-chief of Mkova Magazine, chief photographer of the magazine just as well. I have Takesha with Vault. She's been our fashion stylist for several of the issues. I guess you guys probably figured that out by now. But the main focus right now is to find out a little bit more about her. She's behind the scenes like me. It's kind of hard for me to be in front of the camera, but it's okay. Same thing with her. But she's an excellent creative artist. She knows how to put things together with a lot of different talent that we pull together for. And she's like Johnny on the spot when it comes down to it. So now, Takesha Ball, football.
Hello, everybody.
Now, what got you started?
What got me started, I've always been different since growing up in middle school. I always tell people that my mama used to take me to the thrift store in middle school, in high school. So it kind of started from there. I've never been the person that always tried to be like other people. I was always out of the box. I would be the girl in clogs and yellow pants when everybody else was doing other trends. So it started at a very young age. And as I got older, it just progressed into my passion pretty much. So I just kept it going.
Okay. So what would you say are some different design rooms, trends, and things like that that you kind of draw from?
To be quite honest, I look for more of other people that are doing vintage items. I'm not a trendy person where I go into the mall or I look at designers to pull from. I look for stuff that people have recreated or repurposed is what I call it, just to make it different. Because I don't want the people that I style to look like somebody else. I don't want to have a carbon copy. I want you to be different. So I kind of don't pull from the trends that are out now.
I saw you did. Now, hey, I looked on her Instagram, right? We're gonna have all that information for Instagram and everything. And I saw the photo shoot she did with her son. And I'm gonna tell you right now, the way she styled her son for his graduation, with senior pictures. See, I'm telling you right now, they're not average. They're above average. And he looked like he was a superstar. And see, that's the thing. You bring the right photographer, you bring the makeup artist, the hairstylist, and of course, without a doubt, you bring the right fashion stylist, and they're gonna help give definition to your look. So how was it styling your own son for his graduation?
So to be honest, my son is like the, he doesn't care anything about fashion at all. If you put in jeans, a t-shirt, basketball shorts, he doesn't care. So for me to go to that extent with him was kind of hard. Actually, like I had to like persuade him to, especially when I put that, I don't know if you go back and look at the picture, he has a gold pendant and it's like real big on his neck. That was like, if he could have did anybody else, he wasn't going to do that. But when he saw the pictures, he was like, oh, okay. And everybody kept complimenting that they don't look like senior pictures, they look like album covers. And so,
absolutely, it did.
Yeah.
It did. I looked at it and I was like, wait a minute, what's this guy? But the whole point of it is that what we're trying to do in Mkova is actually let people understand it's more than just taking a Photoshop. It's more than just having a good makeup artist. It's more than just having a good hairstyle. It's more than just having clothes. You have to be able to put all of that together, and that's what actually allows you to make yourself over. Like her son is no different than somebody like me or others who we really don't emphasize on fashion and style, but at the same token, you get someone like that, we can fall in love with. And that's the same that we're trying to do with everybody else. Get them to fall in love with the creative side of themselves and make them look good. So tell me some of the, whether the celebrities or others that you've not worked with that you found to be, not necessarily a challenge, but you found that we kind of turned things around.
I've worked with several people, and nobody really has given me any kind of no issues. I worked with Jay Golden, and he styled with several people, and used a lot of my pieces with. I've worked with, of course, Tamla Mann. I was actually on her reality show, the episode they did for Fashion Week. And those experiences were great for me. Everybody kind of knows my style, and I think when people look for something unique and different, they already know, let me see what you have. So it's like they already know what they're getting when it comes to working with me. So I really haven't had anybody that like has given me any kind of difficulty or it was hard to get them in something.
To get them pushed up.
Yes.
So one of the things is that we want to always focus on, especially in the magazine, is getting people to step outside their comfort zone. And fashion, typically, you know, like my grandma used to say, clothes don't know who they're wearing. So sometimes we see people out there looking like just crazy as I don't know what. And a lot of times is that they're trying and they really don't have a sense of direction in that area. And fashion styling is truly a science to it. From your body shape to everything, the way you're styled, to your hairstyle. And so a lot of times in our professional careers and other things that we're doing, we need to adjust our styling to fit into that dynamic. So someone like Takesha is a perfect person to help you guys to actually do that. Now, we're going to show some of the pictures and things of what she styled in this interview, so you guys can kind of get a visual picture of it. But you can also just go to InCover Magazine. She's all over the place. And the reality of it is she's going to continue to grow. Because as we did the Atlanta shoot. How was the Atlanta shoot?
Oh, that was amazing. It was. Just being able to work with different formats. I call them like canvases. It's like a blank canvas. And a lot of the models, being able to create and them be receptive of what you're trying to do instead of making it about themselves.
Right.
It's about the clothes. So it's almost like an open canvas. It was great being able to do what they have seen.
That's right. And it looks good. She got the cover on for that one. Wait till you see the actual spread. And she knows how to take, she has clothes and she goes all over the country to get. So she gets up from all over the country. So she's just not that one city, I can only find clothes here. She looks everywhere. And when we were in Atlanta, she actually was another boutique owner that she got together with. And she was able to take some of her pieces. And so she can basically do it on the fly, you know. So she's really good at that. So a lot of the shoots that we're going to be doing, in particular today at 2 p.m., or Saturday at 2 p.m., we're going to be doing a drop where we're looking for an individual who wants to be featured in the magazine. An average Joe, an average Jane, who really doesn't know anything about fashion. They're not a model, and they're just looking for a way to just see themselves in a different light. So we're going to actually incorporate the makeup, the hair, the shooting, and the styling to give them a total remakeover. We call it Flip My Look. So Flip My Look is all about taking someone who, you know, dresses one way or just doesn't really know how to put it all together and totally flip their look into a magazine style feel. So literally, it's going to be something that's going to be phenomenal we're going to be doing, and InCover Magazine will be the first one to bring it to you. So Takesha, what's on the drawing board for you?
For me, it's more of recreating, getting more pieces, changing them into different looks so that I can prepare for the next person that is ready to flip my look, flip me fierce, whatever you want to call it. Staying ready. My mind goes all day long. When I look at a piece, I'm like, oh my God, let me see what I can do with this. So it goes all day long. So I'm staying creative in my mind and just ready to put out there.
And so if you're looking for someone like Takesha, because she actually did one of our shoots, it ended up being, I guess, 20 or 30 models. And literally, she just beasted them out. Just switch, change, repurpose one piece for another. And I didn't even realize it. You turn around and say, wow, she killed it. And she's very fast on her feet when it comes down to it. So someone like Takesha is a good person to have on your team. And she's a good person to, you know, for personally, if you want to reach out to her personally to help you, whether you're a professional or you're an artist, you definitely want to have someone who's actually skilled in what they're doing. Any last words?
No, you can. My name is Takesha Johnson. You can check me out on Instagram at vault_by_V. On Facebook, I'm at Vault by V or Takesha Johnson. And on Twitter, I am at The Visionistas.
All right. All right, everybody. Appreciate your time. Enjoy.